हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, साई राम। लेट अस कंटिन्यू विद द सेम लेसन, चैप्टर नंबर 3, डेटा हैंडलिंग। हियर वी हैव लर्न इन द प्रीवियस प्रेजेंटेशन, इफ़ यू गेट अ डेटा लाइक दिस वेयर क्लास एंड द नंबर ऑफ गर्ल्स आर गिवन, यू कैन ईजिली रिप्रेजेंट इट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ बार ग्राफ, एंड वी हैव लर्न बार ग्राफ लास्ट टाइम। बट नाउ इफ द डेटाज आर गिवन इन दिस फॉर्म, वॉट इफ वी हैव डेटा लाइक दिस। Here you can see classes are given and you have got data of number of girls and number of boys also. So how will you represent it? You need to make a double bar graph for it. So today we will learn how to make double bar graph. Now here you can see the numbers. On seeing the numbers, since the number of students are from 20 to 40, so we draw bar graph from 0 to 45 with a gap of 5. So let us draw a double bar graph. Double bar graph looks exactly like bar graph, only here you can see here two data. As we have two data, we can represent both the data in one graph. That is only the difference. So you need graph paper to draw this double bar graph. So you all will have to practice in graph paper, and you will make you will take a graph notebook and you are going to plot this double bar graph. So now here you can see here, this is the x-axis which is drawn, a line is drawn. You also have to draw a horizontal line which is x-axis, and this is the line which is called y-axis, and this is 0 which is called as point of origin. Now before we plot double bar graph, you know that bar graph and double bar graph can be plotted horizontally also as well as vertically also, like this. And when you have two data, when you have two data groups, it can be arranged in this form also. Here you can see number of girls as well as number of boys are there. So we can, here you can see here, for girls we will take blue color, this bars are of girls, and this one line shaded one is of boys. And before we plot, we have to take the scale, and here one unit length is equal to 5 girls, because you can see these all numbers are multiple of 5. So here this numbers are written 5, 10, 15, 20, like this numbers are written. And we are going to plot the graph based on the data. Now first number of girls are 30 here. You can see here first blue bar is still 30, class 5. And always remember, this should be equally spaced. The spacing between the bars should be same. And here this is number of boys, which is 20. Fifth standard has 20 boys. So here you can see it is, you can draw a horizontal line to see it is 20. Now leave, so if you are taking 1 centimeter for the bar, half centimeter you take for girls and half centimeter you take for boys. Now then 1 centimeter you will leave. And then again you will plot the next one here for 6th standard. Number of girls are 35. So here you can see this blue bar is up to 35. And number of boys are 40. So 40 here, you can see 40 is here. So it is up to this much. So this shaded bar is still 40. Then you will leave again equal space, and then you will make the next bar. Half centimeter you will take for girls and half centimeter for boys. Now class 7 has 20 girls. So 20 girls, you can see here 20 is here. You can see here blue bar is still 20. And then 25 boys. So 25 boys, here it is. You can see here, you can draw a line to see whether you are correct or not. Then again you will leave 1 centimeter gap, and then again you will draw for next standard. Here 8th standard, all the classes are written here. And here number of girls and boys, you can put boys also here. And then here for 8th standard, here you can see 25 girls are here, and then 35 boys. You can see here 35 boys are there. Same way you will do for 9th standard, 40 girls here. You can see, you can draw a line, and then here this bar is still 40, and then boys are 20. So you can interpret by this double bar graph that number of girls are more in class 5 and in class 9, whereas in other classes number of boys are more than number of girls. So this kind of bar graph is normally used for comparing some numbers, for comparing the marks. This kind of bar graph is used, double bar graph is used. So let us take one more example. A mathematics teacher wants to see whether the new technique, she applied was effective or not. She takes the scores of 5 weakest children in the quarterly test out of 25 and in the half yearly test out of 25. So this all are the name of the students: Ashish, Arun, Kavish, Maya and Rita. And these are their scores in quarterly test and in half yearly. Now based on this data, we are going to plot double bar graph and teacher will see whether they have performed better in half yearly exam or not. So since the marks are from 9 to 21, you can see we will make a bar graph from 0 to 25 with a gap of 5. So let us see how to make it. This is the data given and we are going to plot bar graph like this. This is x-axis, this is y-axis, and on x-axis we are going to write the name of students: Ashish, Arun. You can see here it's written, students' names are written, and you will plot double bar graph. See here, Ashish got in quarterly exam, he got 10 marks. So here it is till 10, and you have to take, before we plot, we have to take the scale. Already we have decided one unit length is equal to 5 marks. And we have to take colors for it. For quarterly, let us take dark shade. You can take black color. For half yearly, you can draw line shading like this so that we can understand the difference. And if you are taking a bar of 1 centimeter, half centimeter we will take for quarterly exam and half centimeter we will take for half yearly. So by this we can understand. Ashish got 10 mark in quarterly exam, so here it is still 10, and 15 in half yearly, it is still 15, and you can see the shading for half yearly. Same way you have to make for Arun also. Arun got 15 in quarterly exam, so it is still 15, here it is 18. So like this you are going to plot the graph, and you will see here the performance of the children is better in half yearly exam. You can see here this bar is bigger than the quarterly exam bars. So teacher finds that the performance of the students have improved by following the new techniques. So she should follow the new technique of teaching. Now next is, we are going to do exercise 3.3, question number 1. Use the bar graph to answer the following question. So let us see, this is a bar graph given and we have to answer. This kind of questions already we have done before in 6th standard also. Which is the most popular pet? So here you can see this bar is the tallest bar. Since the bar representing cats is the tallest. Here you can see this x-axis is showing pet animals and here in y-axis students' numbers are written. So since the bar representing cats is the tallest, so cat is the most popular pet. Now next is, how many children have dog as a pet? So you can see here, this is the bar for, this bar is representing dog and it is here till 8. The number of children have dog as a pet are 8. So here you can see 8. Now let us go to the next question. Question number 2, read the bar graph which shows the number of books sold by a bookstore during 5 consecutive years and answer the following questions. So let us see the bar graph. This is the bar graph. You can see here on x-axis years are written 1989 to 1993, 90, 1991, 92, 93. And here scale is given 1 centimeter is equal to 100 books. So here you can see 100, 200, like this number of books are written here. Now the question is based on this bar graph. About how many books were sold in 1989, 1990 and 1992. So about they are asking, because you have to write about how many books were sold. Now here you can see in 1989, this is little less than 200. So as you can see, 1 centimeter is equal to 100 books. So here it is all 1 centimeter and almost 3/4 it is covering. So it will be, and as you know, 1 centimeter is 100 book, 100 plus 3/4, 3/4 means 75. So about 175 books were sold in 1989. Then we will see for 1990 also, you see it is little less than 500. So we will write about 475 books were sold in 1990. Then we will see for 1992, if you draw a horizontal line, you can see here it is less than 250, because it is not in the middle, it is little less than that. So about 225 books were sold in 1992. in which year were about 475 books sold? Just now we have seen in 1990, 475 books were sold. About 225 books sold in which year? About 225 books were sold in 1992. So this way you have to find out the answer looking into the graph. Now next question, in which year were fewer than 250 books sold? In which years? So you have to find out the years. Fewer than 250 books means less than 250 books were sold. So here you can see it is less than 175, about 175 books were sold. So we can write this year 1989, and here in 1992 also about 225 books were sold. So we'll write this 2 years, in 1989 and in 1992, fewer than 250 books sold. Now next question, can you explain how you would estimate the number of books sold in 1989? From the graph, we can conclude that in the year 1989, books sold is about 1 centimeter, you can see here 1 centimeter and 3/4 part of 1 centimeter. And as you know, 1 centimeter is equal to 100 books, it is given, the scale is given. So 100, 1 centimeter means 100 books plus 3/4 of 1 centimeter, 3/4 of 100, and 3/4 of 100 is 75. So 100 plus 75 is equal to 175. So about 175 books were sold in 1989. Now we'll go to next question, question number 3, exercise 3.3. Number of children in 6 different classes are given below. Represent the data on a bar graph. So this is the data given, this is the classes, and this is the number of, these all are the number of children. Now based on this, we are going to make a form a bar graph. So this is the bar graph. You can see here, we have learned this in 6th standard also. This is the x-axis, which is showing this classes 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, till 10th standard. And here we have to, before we write the number, we have to take scale. So before writing the scale, we have to see the number, maximum is 135. So we'll take till 140. So one unit length we will take as 10 students. So then easily you can write the numbers here, 10, 20, like this, multiple of 10 we will write till 140. And then we will plot bar graph. First, 5th standard has maximum number of students, that is 135. You can see here the bar is in between 130 and 140. Then 6th standard has 120 students. So you can see here this bar is still 120. You will have to leave equal space. If you are making bar of 1 centimeter, you have to leave equal space here. Then 7th standard you can see 95. Then 8th standard 100. Till 100 you have to make bar like this. 9th standard 90. And 10th standard has the least number of children, that is 80. So this way you will plot bar graph. Now based on this bar graph, how would you choose a scale? Scale on y-axis is 1 centimeter, that is equal to 10 students. We can represent a more clear difference between students of 7th and 9th, because students, there are 95 students in 7th standard and there are 90 students in 9th standard. So easily we can find out the difference, clearly we can show, that's why we have taken this scale. 1 centimeter is equal to 10 students. Now next question, which class has the maximum number of children that we have seen? 5th class has the maximum number of children, that is 135, and 10th class has the minimum number of children, that is 80. So looking into the bar graph, you have to answer this questions. Now third part, find the ratio of the students of class 6 to class 8. So you can see in 6th standard 120 students are there, and in 8th standard 100 students are there. So we have to find out the ratio. This we will divide 120 upon 100. 0, 0 will be cut. 12 and 10, both of them are divisible by 2. 2, 6 are 12. 2, 5 are 10. So the ratio is, you will get answer 6 upon 5. So ratio is 6 is to 5. Now next question is, you will have to plot a double bar graph. The performance of the student in first term and second term is given. This is the performance of the student, of a student in first term and second term, and based on this, and these are the subjects, you have to plot a double bar graph. Let us see how to plot it. Now see here, this is XXX where the subjects are written. There are 5 subjects: English, Hindi, Math, Science, Social Science. So the subjects are written here. And here you can see Y-axis has marks. So before we write marks, we have to take scale. And here you can see maximum is 95. So we'll take scale like this. 1 unit length is equal to 10 mark. And we will take blue color for first term. And this line shaded part for, shaded like this bar should be for second term. So that we can easily distinguish. So the first one, English 67, you can see here, it is still here, 67. So this one is blue bar, that means this is the mark of first term. And then this is the mark for second term, which is still 70. Then you will leave 1 centimeter gap. Now again that one, next 1 centimeter will divide it into two. Half part is for Hindi mark of first term, that is 72. And this is dark blue color, that is of first term. And this line shading is for second term. It is still 65. You can see here, it is still 65. So this way you are going to plot for other subject also. Maths, you can see here, maths is 88. So it is here. And then second term, it is 95. So tall, you can see the bar has gone till here. And then for science, you can see here 81, little more than 80. And then next second term 85. 85 is in between 80 and 90. Then we will take social science 73. It is little more than 70. Here it is. You can see here. And 75. Here it is little more than 73. So 75. So this way you are going to plot double bar graph. Now here we can see here. In maths, the child has performed the best. Let us see, let us answer the question based on this double bar graph. In which subject has the child improved his performance the most? So just now I have told you that in maths, the child has done the best because you can see the bars are very tall here. So you will write, in maths, the child has improved the most. Then in which subject is the improvement the least? So you have to compare both the bars and you will see where the bars are almost of the same height. Here you can see in social science, both the bars are almost of the same height. So answer you will write here, in social science, the improvement is the least. Has the performance gone down in any subject? For that you have to see, you have to compare both the bars. And you have to see in which term the bar has become smaller, it has become shorter. So do you find any subject where the performance has gone down in the second term? I can see here in Hindi the performance has gone down. Here you can see this bar is smaller than first term bar. So we will write here, in Hindi the performance of the child has gone down. So this way you will answer the question. Now children, this is your homework for today. From the same exercise 3.3, this is the data given. You have to draw a double bar graph based on the sports. Which sport is most popular? And then you have to plot it in your graph notebook. Thank you.